Hey everyone, welcome to Memorial Stadium in Baltimore. The card says 77, but we're really in 1979. We're in Game 7 of the 1975 World Series between the host Baltimore Orioles, managed by Earl Weaver, and the We Are Family Pittsburgh Pirates, managed by Chuck Tanner. Game 7 of the World Series, starting pitchers Scott McGregor and Jim Bibby. Oh, and by the way, this is Payoff Pitch Baseball. We use the dice version of the game. And let's go through our starting lineups very quickly for each team. Leading off and playing center field is Omar Moreno. And these are the actual lineups from Game 7, in case you're interested. Omar Moreno will lead off and play center. Tim Foley bats second and plays short. The Cobra, Dave Parker, is in right field. He will bat in the third position. Hitting in the cleanup position is left fielder Bill Robinson. Batting fifth is Pops Willie Stargell. He's at first base. Hitting sixth is the third baseman Bill Madlock. Batting seventh and catching, because of the lefty on the mound, they're going with the right-handed hitting catching of Steve Nicosia. And Ed Ott is on the bench. And batting eighth, playing second base, is scrap iron Phil Garner. And, of course, batting ninth and using batting card number one is Jim Bibby. All right, for the Baltimore Orioles, leading off and playing center field will be Al Bumrey. Batting second, playing shortstop, is Kiko Garcia. Hitting third and playing right field is Ken Singleton. Batting cleanup at first base is Eddie Murray. Hitting fifth and playing left field is John Lowenstein. Batting sixth and playing third base is Doug DeSense. Hitting seventh and catching is Rick Dempsey. Batting eighth, playing second base, is Rich Dower. And batting ninth is the pitcher Scott McGregor, who ironically is using pitching card hitting number three. So even though he did not hit during the season, he's listed as a better hitter than Jim Bibby. Of course, in 79, they did not use the DH in the World Series. It was alternate every year. Back in the 70s, and in this particular year, the pitchers had to hit. All right, I think we're all ready to go. Score sheets all filled out with the appropriate ratings for all the players. So we're going to go ahead and get going here. And what I like to do sometimes is roll the two D6s first to kind of put us on the pitcher card and tell us where we are, and then read the two D10s. And when I play the black D10 is the 10s, and the white D10 is the 1s. So if I happen to roll this roll right here, it would be 48, not 84. So you can see what I'm using there. The all black D10 is the 10s, and the all white is the 1s. All right, we'll get ready to go here. Scott McGregor facing Omar Moreno. Game 7 is now underway, and it's a 7, so under McGregor, we're in play. All right, let's see if Moreno can do something with that. And he rolls a 76, so that's probably not going to do anything. That's way out of range. And 76 is actually going to be a fly ball to center field, F8. Cards are kind of small print, and the camera's not that great. Trying to get this focused in here, but I don't think it's going to work. So I just have to trust me. That's an F8 right there. So Moreno, one of these days I'll actually get a decent camera maybe. And actually something to hold it with instead of my hand. But maybe that's down the road. Right now, just have to deal with what I have. All right, here's Tim Foley facing McGregor. It's an 8, which is tough. So we're in the tough category. Can Foley fight off the tough pitch from the lefty? It's a 0-5. So it's a 5. Tough 5. 1-5 is a strikeout. So Foley unable to do anything with that McGregor pitch. It got in a tough location, and he was unable to deal with it, so he strikes out. Two outs, and Dave Parker, the batter. It's a 3, which is defense. All right, we're going to see who the defensive check's going to be on. It's a 67. So if we go to the charts for our defense and check on number 67, 67 says we're going to be looking at an error possibility on the third baseman. The error possibility on the third baseman. I've got a kitty on the table. I've got to move real quick. There we go. All right. Error check on the third baseman. Third baseman in this case is Doug DeSense. He has an error rating of 4. So we go to our ballpark. Error rating of 4. And we see that 1 to 30 is going to be an error. Anything else is going to be an out. So basically, we're looking for anything 30 or less to make it an error. It's a 91, so he made the play successfully. Now, the question is, was it a ground out? Was it a pop out? What exactly happened there? So I'm going to roll the two D6s and find that out. It's an 11, so we go to the out chart. Out chart says ground ball, GB. So it's a ground ball 5-3. Parker cued it off the end of the bat. DeSensei handled it without an issue. And the top of the first is in the books with no score. And that will bring up the Orioles for their first time at the plate. Al Bumbry will slide into the batting position here against Jim Bibby as Earl Weaver sends his troops out for the top of the first, or bottom of the first, I should say. Here's Al Bumbry facing Jim Bibby. It's an 8, which is in play. So Al Bumbry is going to try to get something going here, but he won't this time. 96. So a 96 is at the bottom of the out chart. That is a F9 fly ball to right field. And Bumbry is out. Flying out to Parker. Here is Kiko Garcia. It's a 4. 4 is in play. And Garcia a 47 on the in play. That's out of range. 47 ends up being a pop up to the shortstop. P6. So pop out to Tim Foley for out number 2. 2 up, 2 down quickly for the Orioles. They're not faring any better than the Pirates did in the top of the first. Here is Ken Singleton. It's a 7, which is tough. And it's a 11, a tough 11. So a tough 11 against a righty, that is a strikeout. So Singleton down on strikes. Both pitchers sail through the first inning. And we go to the bottom of the, or sorry, the top of the second with no score. And Bill Robinson, the batter for the Pirates, to face McGregor. As I switch these in place here, there we go. All right, McGregor facing Bill Robinson. It's a 7, it's a 7. 7 is in play. And it's a 46. 7 and a 46 in play. 46 gets lefties, is out of range. So the 46 falls into a ground ball to third, G5. So it's a 5-3 ground out as Robinson pulls one down the line, but DeSensei handles it. One away for Pops, Willie Stargell. And we get a 9. 9 is in play. And we get a 47. An in play 47. That's definitely out of range. That's a pop out to the shortstop, Kiko Garcia, for out number 2. So McGregor rolling along here. Now we'll have to face Bill Madlock. Midseason acquirement by the Pirates from the Giants in 79. It's an 8. That's tough. See if Madlock can handle a tough one. It's a 60, so probably not. 60, tough, only goes to 43, so it's in the out range, which is a ground ball to second. So Rich Dower handles that one easily. And there's nothing doing for the Pirates here in the top of the second. We go to the bottom of the second with still no score. And steady Eddie Murray will lead things off for the Orioles against Jim Bibby. He's a switch hitter. He will be batting left this at bat against Bibby. It's a 3. 3 is defense, is wheelhouse. I'm sorry. 3 is wheelhouse. So he has put one in Eddie Murray's wheelhouse. And the question is, can Murray do something with it? He's got a 1 to 33 chance of a home run. Or 1 in 33 on the 2D10s to get a home run. And he did it. It's a 10. So Eddie Murray has gone yard. Leadoff home run off of Jim Bibby. He put one right down the middle. And Murray did not miss it. It's 1-0 Orioles, and that'll bring up John Lowenstein. And, of course, in a Game 7, the bullpens are always on alert. Quick hooks are inevitable. All right, so 10. 10 is patient on Bibby. Lowenstein, a 41. 41 patient is a walk. So John Lowenstein will draw a walk as the Orioles continue here in the bottom of the second with the first two runners being successful. Here's Doug DeSensei. It's a five, and that is tough. So maybe Bibby can bounce back here on a tough at bat. And we get a 57, a tough 57. Tough 57 for DeSense is actually going to be a base hit. It's a single, and anytime you get a single off the tough variety, it's only a one base advancement. So Lowenstein will stop at second base. But three consecutive base runners been successful, or batters have been successful for the Orioles. Here's Rick Dempsey. He could bunt. He could bunt here, although Earl Weaver was not big on bunting, and his bunt rating is a D, so that's not very good either. So they're going to let him hit away. They got Bibby on the ropes. They're going to try to see if they can't finish it here. Five is tough, though. Tough. Tough 61. Tough 61 is in the out range. 61 is a ground ball to second, and we have to check the double play ratings. The 2D6s were a 5. 5 is less than 8. 5 is less than 8. It is a double play. A double play. And that's going to go 4-6-3. So Dempsey hits into the 4-6-3 double play. That's what they were afraid of by not bunting. But you take your chances. And now there's two away for Rich Dower. So Rich Dower, and with Lowenstein on third and Rich Dower up, they could walk Dower and face the pitcher, McGregor. But Dower was not a very good hitter against right-handed pitching, so they're going to go ahead and take their chances here. Four is in play, and a 34. In play, 34 is in the out range. It only goes to 23. A 34 is a ground ball to first, so Pops Stargell will field it himself to end the inning, but the Orioles do pick up the run on the Eddie Murray leadoff homer, and after two complete, it's Baltimore 1 and Pittsburgh nothing. All right, top of the third, and Steve Nicosia will lead things off. Bottom of the order for the Pirates, Nicosia, Garner, and Bibby. Nicosia, a 5, which is ballpark. So we're going to check the ballpark and see if he's found the wheelhouse or not. It's a 42. And Memorial Stadium, right-handed batters, 42 is in the wheelhouse. So we're going to have a wheelhouse at bat for Nicosia against the lefty. A 1-22 will be a home run. So we'll see what he can do here. Up to 50 is a base hit. It's a 4. It's a 4. So that's a home run for Steve Nicosia. So Nicosia tells Eddie Murray, anything you can do, I can do too. And that's referring to the leadoff home run. And Nicosia, who only hit 4 all year, but all 4 were against left-handed pitching. So he found the wheelhouse against McGregor. And we got a tie ball game. Here's Phil Garner. 7 is in play. And we've got a 63. In play 63 is well within the out range. That's a ground ball to second base. So Dower will field that. One second baseman grounding to another for out number 2. And that will bring up the pitcher spot, Jim Bibby. And, of course, he uses pitcher hitting card number 1. So we'll see how that plays out. Runner, nobody on and one out. It's a 7, so that's in play. In play, 85 doesn't look good, no matter what card you're on. But pitcher hitting card number 1, and 85 is going to put him as a ground ball to short. So at least he made contact, but he hits a weak grounder to Kiko Garcia for out number 2. Now we're back to the top of the order, and Omar Moreno. It's a 6. 6 is tough. 61. 61 tough against a lefty. He just found the strikeout. Of 62, he would have had a double, but he's got a strikeout. 61 is a strikeout against the lefty, and the Pirates are done here in the third, but the Steve Nicosia leadoff home run has tied the ball game, and now we're tied at 1 going to the bottom of the third. Jim Bibby back out on the hill with that run support now. Hopefully that's going to get him to be where he needs to be and kind of perk him up a little bit. Let's see. Here's Jim Bibby. It's a 5. 5 is tough. Here's Al Bumrey. 75. Bumrey 75 tough is well out of range. 75 puts him as a fly ball to center field. So One center fielder fly. I'm sorry, that was the wrong at bat. I should have had a pitcher card placement here. That was actually Scott McGregor's at bat. So McGregor was tough 75, and he used his pitcher hitting card number 3. Not that it's going to matter. 75 is going to make that it's a fly ball to center field, so it's the same result. So it is McGregor who flies out to center. One away. Now Al Bumry can come to the plate. Debbie, it's a 4. That's in play. So Bumry says he likes that a little bit better than being tough. See if he can do something with it. 49 in play. Nope, that's out of range. 49's a pop-up to the shortstop, Tim Foley. So that is 2 outs very quickly for Kiko Garcia. Every time I see Kiko Garcia, I think of that Worcestershire sauce called brand Kiko Man. All right, it's a 6. It's patient. Patient and a 38. Patient 38 for Kiko Garcia is going to be a base hit. He just missed a triple, but he'll take his single, a 2-out single for Garcia. And that brings up Ken Singleton. Ken Singleton. It's a 12. 12 is ballpark, so we're going to check and see if this is in the wheelhouse or not. Memorial Stadium, 1 to 39 will be in the wheelhouse. It's a 32. It is in the wheelhouse, so we're going to check Singleton's wheelhouse. And he's got some good chances here. 1 to 51 is going to be a homer. It's a 38. So Ken Singleton, a 2-run shot by Ken Singleton as Bibby let one go in a bad location, and Singleton did not miss it. It is now a 3-1 ball game, and now the Pirate bullpen is loosening in a hurry. Enrique Romo, the righty, is loosening. So here's Eddie Murray. It's a 5, which is tough. And the result is a 6. A tough and a 6. Tough and a 6 is a strikeout to end the inning. But it was that 2-out single by Garcia that kept the inning going and allowed Singleton to come up and hit that 2-run homer. So after 3 complete, it is the Orioles 3 and the Pirates 1. All right, top of the 4th, and the Pirates have their work cut out for them. Here's Tim Foley. Foley a 10, which is patient. And it's a 67. Patient 67 is well out of range against the lefty. That's a fly to center. So Foley flies out to Bumry. One away. That brings up the Cobra, Dave Parker. It's an 8, which is tough. And it's a 00. How about that? We got a rare play. A rare play. When you roll the 00, you get the rare play. So we go to our rare play chart with the bases empty. So we're going to be using rare play chart, bases empty. And we're going to roll the 2d6s and see what we get from this 2 to 12 check. So we're going to roll the 2d6s and see what happens here. We get an 11. An 11 says, walk, pitcher ejected for arguing call. How about that? McGregor walks Parker, doesn't like the call by the home plate umpire, and gets tossed. Earl Weaver, not a happy camper whatsoever. So while we sort all this out and figure out who the new pitcher is going to be, he's going to have as much time to warm up as he needs it. But Earl Weaver, in deep discussions right now with the home plate umpire, it's a wonder he doesn't get ejected as well. But we'll be right back with the new Oriole pitcher in just a moment. Okay, new Oriole pitcher is Sammy Stewart, as things have calmed down at least a little bit here at the stadium. Can't quite close the book on McGregor yet, but he did pitch 3 1/3 innings. He only gave up the one hit, which was the home run to Nicosia. He walked one, which is what got him ejected, and he struck out 2. Now, Parker on first base is his responsibility, but Sammy Stewart's going to see if he can't take care of that for him. Bill Robinson to lead things off. It's a 5, which is tough. Right there in the middle of his tough category. And it's a 62. A 62. Tough 62 is a strikeout. Strikeout. So, Sammy Stewart starting things off well for the Orioles, making Earl Weaver feel a little bit better. Here's Pops Stargell. 7, which is patient. Patient 41. Patient 41. That's a base hit.
A base hit by Stargell.
And in the patient category, again, one runner advancement. So Parker will stop at second base. Two outs, two on for Bill Madlock. It's an eight. An eight is patient. Patient 26 is a walk. So now the bases are loaded with two outs. And it's up to Nikosha again. He had the home run last time, but that was against a lefty. Against righties, he only hit 170 on the season, but you'd hate to make a move on your catcher so quickly. But Chuck Tanner's going to do it. Chuck Tanner's going to, in an unprecedented move, take out a catcher whose only at bat was a home run and replace him with a left-handed hitter with some pop in a pinch hitting role, trying to catch lightning in a bottle. We've got John Milner, who's going to come in and pinch hit, and then Ed Ott will come in and catch going forward. But John Milner, down 3-1 in the fifth inning of Game 7 of a World Series, or the fourth inning, I should say, they're going to go for it here. So we've got Milner in a pinch hitting role. Like I said, you take out the guy who's got the only hit being in a home run for your team, but that was against a lefty, not against a righty. So Milner stepping in there now against Sammy Stewart. Bases loaded and two outs. I've never done that before. That was kind of unusual. I don't even caught it on camera. I accidentally rolled 1D6 and 1D10 together. Got so geared up for this at bat, I didn't watch what I was grabbing. Okay. Let's try it here. It's a five, which is tough, so that's going to make it tough for Milner. See if he can do something with it. It's a three. That's not going to happen. A tough three is a strikeout. So Nikosha, anybody would have struck out on that at bat because of the tough quality. So nothing doing for the Pirates. And like I said, Ed Ott will now take over as the new catcher. And let's check his ratings real quick, so we can fill in the score sheet. Where is his ratings? Oh, all right. Ed Ott, he is a C-rated catcher. He is an error rating of 5. He's got an arm rating of 3. And he runs as a 7. All right, so that's all now squared away. So now the Orioles will be coming to the bat. They escape potential problems in that inning, although they did lose their starter, McGregor. So, and now we can close the book on McGregor, just the one run allowed. So here's John Lowenstein to lead things off. He walked his first time up. It's a 7, which is tough. And Lowenstein, a 53, tough. That's actually going to be a double. So John Lowenstein cracks a double to lead things off. He fought off that tough pitch and plunked it down the left field line for opposite field double. That'll bring up Doug DeSense, and now the Pirate bullpen, again, Enrique Romo is loosening. It's an 8. 8 is in play. DeSense in play, a 37. In play, 37 is out of range. 37 is a ground ball to first. So on the ground ball to first, that will move Lowenstein over to third base. So good, solid baseball there by the Orioles, advancing that runner, getting the job done, hitting to the right side of the infield. That's baseball 101. The infield will now have to come in. Here's Rick Dempsey. It's a 9, which is tough. Dempsey, a 63. Tough 63 is out of range. 63, ground ball to second. And with the infield in, that will be an out. Let me check something here real quick. I think I have to look at a chart for the infield in, so I'll be right back. Okay, I cannot find the chart I need. I'm going to go by the default that I believe to be correct. I don't know if somebody can correct me on this, I'm sure. But since the 9 was tough, I'm going to say that the runner did not score. If it was an in play or something like that, that were patient, I would have said he would have scored. But since it was off a tough at bat, we're going to say that he held, or he had to hold. So grounder to third, and the runner had to hold, so Dempsey is out 5-3. I'm sure I probably did that incorrectly, but on the fly, that's the best I can come up with. All right, that's why I usually prefer the fast action cards, but I know a lot of other people prefer dice, so that's why I'm doing the dice game. All right, it's a 7, which is tough for Rich Dower. He gets a hit, it won't matter. Tough 13, but he's going to strike out. Tough 13, he will strike out, and the inning is over. So nothing doing for the Orioles here in the fourth. We go to the bottom of the top of the fifth, rather. Score Orioles 3 and the Pirates 1. All right, top of the fifth, Sammy Stewart is on for his second inning of work. He'll be facing the bottom portion of the order. Phil Garner will lead things off, and then the pitcher spot, Bibby, is up, but he's going to be pulled back, and we're going to get a pinch hitter. Mike Easler will pinch hit for him, and then Enrique Romo will come in to pitch the bottom of the fifth for the Pirates. First things first, here's Phil Garner. And we got an 8, which is patient. And that's a 5, so a patient and a 5, that relates to a walk for Phil Garner. So he draws a leadoff walk, and that brings up the pinch hitter, John Milner. Mike Easler. Milner hit pinch hit already in this game. This is Easler. It's an 8, which is patient again. And we get a 65. Patient 65 is in the out range. 65 is a fly ball to center field. So Easler not able to get the job done. He is out number 1. And then it brings up the top of the order, Omar Moreno. Moreno is 0 for 2 with a strikeout. It's a 5, which is tough. And it's a 51. Tough 51 is a base hit. He just found it. Omar Moreno. A base hit, but on a tough result, the runner advancement is only one base. So runners at first and second now. Normally Moreno would be a good base stealer, but with Garner in front of him, he cannot steal. So Tim Foley is up. He's also 0 for 2 with a strikeout. We got a 6. 6 is tough. 6 tough. And we get a 74. Tough 74. 74 is a fly ball to center field again. So Foley is out number 2, and that'll bring up Dave Parker, the Cobra. He's also 0 for 2 he's 0 for 1 with a walk. He was the batter that McGregor walked to get ejected. All right, 9 is patient. So 9 is patient, and it's a 63, patient 63. And he gets plunked, so he got walked the first time, or last time up, and this time he gets hit by a pitch. Don't know if there was anything to that. Don't know why they would be upset about Parker for an umpire throwing McGregor out, but a little suspicious there, but have to deal with it. All right, now here's Bill Robinson with the bases loaded and 2 outs. The Pirates were here last inning, bases loaded, 2 outs. Earl Weaver smoking another cigarette back in the clubhouse. Doesn't want to watch. It's an 8. 8 is patient. Could he walk in the a possible run here? It's a 74, so I don't think that's going to happen. Patient 74 is a fly to center again. So all 3 outs were fly balls to center. And Sammy Stewart goes through 2 rough innings, but puts zeros on the board, which is the bottom line, to make Earl Weaver happy. Earl can come back from the clubhouse now. We go to the bottom of the fifth. Score still 3-1. Close the book on Bibby. He went 4 innings, gave up 5 hits, 3 runs, all earned based on the 2 home runs he gave up. 1 walk, 3 strikeouts. And the new pitcher is going to be right-hander Enrique Romo. So Enrique Romo, and the leadoff batter in the inning is set to be Sammy Stewart, but he will not bat. He has pitched his 2 innings and done his job, so he will be called back for a pinch hitter, and the pinch hitter for the Orioles will be the left-handed hitting Pat Kelly. So Pat Kelly will come on to pinch hit here for Sammy Stewart. So Pat Kelly leads off the fifth, bottom of the fifth, as a pinch hitter. And the new pitcher for the Orioles, warming up in their bullpen, see who that might be. They're going to look at it. It looks like it's going to be They used Sammy Stewart already. He was the long man. Looks like it might be Tippy Martinez, or it could be Tim Stoddard. They're going to go with Tippy Martinez. So Tippy Martinez, the lefty, is going to be the new pitcher in the top of the sixth. But right now, it's Enrique Romo facing Pat Kelly. Enrique Romo facing Pat Kelly. Righty on lefty matchup. 12. 12 is wheelhouse. So Enrique Romo comes in and puts one right in the wheelhouse right away for Pat Kelly, who does very well against right-handed pitching. He hit 301 against him. It's a 19, so that's gone. Pat Kelly, a pinch-hit home run. So Earl Weaver was known for the three-run homer, but in this case, he can be known for three homers because that was the third home run hit. This one, a pinch-hit job by Pat Kelly, and Enrique Romo is rudely introduced to the ball game with that, giving up that home run. So it is now a 4-1 ball game. And here is Al Bumry. Bumry, an 11, which is in play. And it's a 63. In play 63 is a fly to left. So Bumry flies out to Bill Robinson in left field for out number one. Brings up Kiko Garcia. Six. Six is in play. Kiko, and it's 11. In play 11, that's going to be a base hit. Kiko Garcia, base hit. So Enrique Romo, maybe he warmed up too long in the bullpen. He just doesn't seem to be on his game right now. Here's Ken Singleton. It's a 7, which is tough, so he finally found a tough spot. Here's Singleton. It may not matter. Well, it's a 1. It's a 1, so that's a strikeout. Thought it was going to be something else there, but it turned out to get in on his kitchen and struck him out for out number 2. And that'll bring up Eddie Murray. So he's not out of the woodwork yet. 5 is patient. Eddie Murray is a 2. Patient and a 2 is a walk. So the inning continues for John Lowenstein. Lowenstein doubled his last time up. It's a 6, which is in play. And it's a 3, in play number 3. He has doubled again. In play number 3 is a double. And so that will score Kiko Garcia with another run, second run of the inning. And that will move Eddie Murray to third base. So runners at second and third with two outs for Doug DeSense. It's a 2, so we're in the wheelhouse again, and Romo may be done for this game, as he put one in the wheelhouse again. And it's a 35. That's a home run. Doug DeSense just cracked a 3-run shot. And Romo, looking more like, pitching more like Tony Romo than he is Enrique Romo right now. He's just giving up a 3-run bomb. And that makes it run number 5 in the inning. It is now 8-1. And Earl Weaver can relax a little bit now. Rick Dempsey's in the game, or up to bat now with two outs and the bases empty. Chuck Tanner's like, why bother bringing a reliever now? It's pretty much, the damage is done. So it's a 12, so he's in the wheelhouse again. Dempsey, this time it's a 66, so he's going to miss an opportunity here and hit a ground ball to second to mercifully end the inning. So that's it. That's going to be one inning for Romo, and that's it. 5 runs, all earned. For Romo, he gave up 2 home runs. He did manage to strike out a batter, and he walked a batter, and gave up 3 hits, 2 homers and a single. So not an eventful or memorable day for Romo. He will be out of there, but after 5 innings, it is now the Orioles 8 and the Pirates 1. And Tippy Martinez is in for the Orioles, and he will be the new pitcher. Sammy Stewart did his job. He went an inning and 2/3 of shutout relief to kind of stem the tie between the starter and the bullpen. Let's see, he got 2 strikeouts. He walked 2, struck out 2, and he gave up 2 hits. So 2s were abounding here. All right, Willie Stargell set to lead things off here against Tippy Martinez. It's a 3. Which is defense. So we have a defensive check. And it's a 38, so the defensive check on a 38. Let's pull out the old defensive card here, chart. Should have had that handy, but was looking for the infield in thing, and now I've mixed up my charts. So, let's see if I can find this here without any more trouble. That's debatable. Boy, I'm having a real tough time trying to find this chart. Let me pause the video. We'll come back. Okay, as normal, that was on the bottom of something I didn't think it would be at, but I finally found it. So we're looking at 38 on the defense, and that is an error check on the pitcher, Tippy Martinez. So Tippy Martinez has an error rating of 3. So he's got an error rating of 3, and that means 1 to 38, he will make an error. So it's a 1 to 38 for an error, and he does make an error. It's a 10, so it's an error on Tippy Martinez. Let's see what kind of an error. What kind of an error? We're going to roll the 2D6 to determine that. It's a 10. 10 says one base error. All right. So it's an error on Tippy Martinez to start the ball game, or start the inning, I should say. Start his ball game. It's an E1. Starger will reach on the E1. And that'll bring up Bill Madlock. So a little bit shaky there for Martinez. It's a 6, which is tough, so maybe he's going to rebound here against Mr. Madlock. And we got a 92. 92 in the outrange. 92 is a fly to left. So one away as Mr. Madlock is retired. Here's Ed Ott. It's a 7, so that's tough. And it's a 26. Tough 26 against a lefty is a strikeout. Two down, and that'll bring up Scrap Iron Phil Garner. Stargell still at first on the error. It's another tough. They're going to start singing that John Cafferty song, Things Are Tough All Over, if they keep this up. Another tough check, and it's 53. It was a 3 there, not a 7. 53 tough is a base hit. It's a base hit. Stargell will go to second. And we're going to get a pinch hitter for Romo, so he would have been relieved anyway, even if he had pitched well due to the pinch hitter. But at least now you can pinch hit for him and get try to salvage something here. So they're going to go to a pinch hitter, and it's going to be Lee Lacy. So Lee Lacy, who hits left-handers pretty well, he's going to be in there to pinch hit. Lee Lacy. He hit 277 on the 79 season against lefties. So he's in there to pinch hit with two on and two out. Pirates have left a lot of runners on base in this game. See if they do it again. 11 is Patient. So it could be looking for a walk here. Patient 70. It's in the out range. 70 is a ground ball to second, and the inning is over. So another missed opportunity for the Pirates. They let it go by the wayside. They are done here in the top of the sixth. We go to the bottom of the sixth. New pitcher on for the Pirates, and we'll be right back. New Pirates pitcher is lefty Grant Jackson. Now for the Orioles, Rich Dower is going to lead off, and then the pitcher spot is coming up, so we're going to get a pinch hitter for Tippy Martinez. Here's Dower, 7, which is in play, and a 79. So 79 is going to put him in a ground ball to short. One away, and now we're going to go to another pinch hitter for the Orioles, and this time it's going to be a right-hander. Last time Kelly, the left-hander, got the big hit. This time it's Lee May. So Lee May, who was usually the DH during the season, he will pinch hit here in the bottom of the sixth for Tippy Martinez, and Martinez went one inning, gave up a hit, and that was it. He got a strikeout, and that was it. But he did leave the bases with two runners on, so he got out of a jam there. And the new pitcher for the Orioles coming up, we're not sure who it's going to be yet, but we'll figure it out. Right now, Lee May is up. It's a 10. 10 is ballpark. And 95, so a 95 means we're in play. In play 51 against the lefty is an out. That's going to be a ground ball to third. So ground ball to to Sensei, I'm sorry, to Madlock at third for two outs, and that'll bring up Al Bumbry. It's a five, which is in play. In play 57, in play 57 is a fly to left, and the inning's over. So nothing doing there for the Orioles in the sixth. But after six complete, it's still the Orioles comfortably in front, 8-1. All right, new Oriole pitcher is right-hander Tim Stoddard. He will be on to face the top of the order, Moreno, Foley, and Parker here in the seventh. It's 12, which is wheelhouse, so he came in and put one right in Moreno's wheelhouse. Moreno, not a power hitter, though. But he might this time. It's a 16. 16 is a triple, so Omar Moreno with a leadoff triple to start the seventh as Stoddard put one right where he shouldn't have. But he is working with a seven-run lead, so take it with a grain of salt, I guess. All right, defensive check, and it's an 11. A defensive check, and 11 is the range of the second baseman, Rich Dower. Rich Dower, his range is an F. He's got F range. So on the ballpark chart, F range means he didn't have a very good range at all. So 1 to 66 is going to be a hit here. 1 to 66, and he'll have a base hit, which he does. It's a 50, so that's a base hit for Foley. And that will score Moreno to make it an 8-2 ball game. Not that the Orioles are panicking or anything, but you don't like to see, if you're the Orioles, you don't like to see two runners have this much success right away. Here's Dave Parker. It's a 4, which is patient, so Stoddard's in the patient range. You're certainly going to want to start walking guys. 23 patient is a walk. So runners are at first and second, nobody out. And you don't want to give up free base runners because they can put a 5 spot up the same as the Orioles did. All right, here's Bill Robinson. It's an 8, so that is tough. That might help. Tough 71, though, for Bill Robinson is a base hit. He just found it, a base hit. One runner advancement for everyone since it's off of the tough and there's nobody out and they're down by 7, so there's no point in risking the base runners. And now here's Willie Stargell, bases loaded. If he puts one out of here, all of a sudden we got a ball game. All right, it's an 11, which is defense, so we have another defensive check. And it's a 41, and this time the defensive check on a 41 goes to the catcher error rating, which is Rick Dempsey, and his error rating as a catcher is error rating number 4. He's got a 4 error rating. So 1 to 30 looks like it'll be an error. Anything above that will be an out, and then we have to figure out what kind of an out. So let's see here. It's a 98, so that's definitely an out. But now we need to go to the out chart. Need to get the out chart and figure out what kind of an out, and is it a forced play? Do the runners advance, or exactly what's going on here? So I've got to go find my out chart. All right, got that right here. So I'm going to roll 2d6s and see what happens here on the out chart. We're looking in the catcher category for the out chart. It's an 8. An 8 is a ground ball fielder's choice. Ground ball fielder's choice. So let's see what it says here. Ground ball fielder's choice. If forced, lead runner out. So it's a tapper in front of the plate. Dempsey's going to field it and step on the plate to force Foley at the plate. Everybody else will move up. So it's a 2 unassisted fielder's choice. Very unusual play there, but with the bases loaded, that's what happened. So force was completed. There is one out now. Bases are still loaded for Bill Madlock. Couldn't turn the double play. Stargell was able to somehow motor his way down to first base and beat the relay, but 10. 10 is tough for Stoddard. Madlock, tough 92. Tough 92. Tough 92 is a fly ball to left field. And tough left field. Now we've got to figure out if it's a sac fly or not. So let's check the charts here and we'll be right back. Okay, we're going to check the out chart and see whether it's a deep fly or a short fly. It's a nine, and a nine says deep fly. So deep fly. Deep fly, outfielder makes running catch in the outfield, runner on third base with a run rating of seven or more scores. All right, the runner on third is Parker. Does he have a seven run rating? Parker has a seven run rating, so he will score. It's a sacrifice fly to left field for Bill Madlock. That will score Parker with the second run of the inning. Cuts the lead to 8-3. And leaves runners at first and second with two outs for Ed Ott. So Ed Ott with a chance. Still got two runners on to do something with. Eight is tough. Tough and 50. Tough and 50. And he's done it. That's a base hit. It's a single. But in the since the result was tough, they're going to have to hold the base runners, I believe. Let me see if there's a two-out variance on that. I believe there is a two-out variance on that, so let's double-check it here. Let's see here. Basic runner advancement. Batter's card selected. In play. All right, if it's a single, runners advance one base. With two outs, all runners advance an extra base. Okay, so two outs says that they advance the extra base, so that's what we're going to go with. Base hit for Ed Ott will drive in Bill Robinson from second base for the third run of the inning, and Stargell will go to third. So runners are at the corners with two outs, and three runs are in. It's all of a sudden an 8-4 ball game, and here's Phil Garner. It's a 10, which is tough, and we got a 20. Tough 20. Tough 20 is a strikeout to end the inning. But Stoddard comes in and gives up three runs. And we go to seventh inning stretch with the score, the Orioles 8 and the Pirates 4. Bottom of the seventh, new pitcher for the Pirates is Don Robinson, the hard-throwing right-hander. He'll be facing numbers 2, 3, and 4 hitters, Kiko Garcia, Singleton, and Murray. 7, which is tough. And a 22, tough 22, is a strikeout. So Don Robinson coming in, see if he can't settle things down a little bit after that Romo implosion 2 innings ago. Here's Singleton. Grant Jackson pitched 1 inning with nothing across, in case you're curious. 10 patient. Singleton, 91. That's in the out range, and a 91 is a ground ball to second. Two down, and that'll bring up Eddie E. Drinkenby Murray. It's a 9. That's patient. And it's a 46. Patient 46. Is a base hit. Patient 46 is a base hit. So Eddie Murray gets a two-out single, and that'll bring up Lowenstein. He's doubled the last two times up. It's an 8. 8 is tough. May not double this time. It's a 14. Tough 14 is a strikeout. So Don Robinson stems the tide a little bit for his team. Try to keep him in the ball game. We go to the 8th inning with the score. The Orioles 8 and the Pirates 4, and we'll be right back with new Oriole pitcher. Okay, top of the 8th, new Oriole pitcher Don Stanhouse. Stan the Man Unusual is in the ball game. Actually, he came in a double switch as the last out was made by John Lowenstein, the left fielder, so he will bat in Lowenstein's spot in the number 5 hole. And coming in to play left field and batting 9th is going to be Gary Renicky. So Gary Renicky will now be the new 9th place hitter. Don Stanhouse batting 5th. He comes in and he will be facing a pinch hitter because we're at the pitcher spot. So we get a pinch hitter for the Pirates, and they're running out of pinch hitters very quickly. But they're going to go to Manny Sanguian, the old guy. Manny Sanguian's going to pinch hit here for Don Robinson to lead off the top of the 8th. He did hit 360 against righties in limited duty. So let's see what he can do here. Manny Sanguian. It's a 10, which is tough, so that might be trouble. It's a 14. Tough 14 is a strikeout. So Sanguian not able to get it done. He strikes out. And now we're back to the top of the order and Omar Moreno. Stan the Man Unusual with a patient roll. And it's a 6. Patient 6 is another strikeout. So Don Stanhouse, full pack as Earl Weaver would like to call him. Because he would smoke a full pack of cigarettes because he would walk the bases loaded and strike out the side to end it. but it would make Earl Weaver nervous. All right, here's Tim Foley. Seven is tough out. And Foley is a 26. Foley 26 is going to be a base hit. So Foley found the base hit in the tough category. That's his second hit of the game. And that'll bring up Dave Parker with two outs. Parker can jack one here. We'd really have a ball game. It's an eight again, which is patient. Maybe he can walk. 24, I think he will walk. Yes, he will. So that's a walk, and that brings up Bill Robinson. With two on and two outs, all of a sudden the tying run's on deck. So here's Bill Robinson, and this is the kind of thing that makes Earl Weaver crazy about Don Stanhouse. 10 is tough, so that might do it. We will see. It's a 36. Tough 36 is a strikeout. So Stanhouse strikes out the side around everything else he gave up, a hit and a walk. But we go to the bottom of the eighth with the score remaining, the Orioles 8 and the Pirates 4. We'll be right back with the new Pirates pitcher. Okay, we closed the book on Don Robinson. One inning pitched, gave up a hit and struck out two. Kent DeColvey coming in to pitch the bottom of the eighth. It's usually their closer, but there's no save situation. So the best save they can do in a game 7 is to try to keep the score right where it is. So he is in there to face DeSensei, Dower, and Renicky. DeColvey, a 7, is in play. And it's a 55. 55 in play is a fly to right. One away. And that will bring up the catcher, Rick Dempsey. Dempsey, a 7, which is in play. And an 87. 87 is a grounder to short. Two quick outs. And now we got Rich Dower. So I skipped a batter. Renicky may not bat at all now, depending on if anybody gets a hit. It's a 10, which is patient. So if Dower walks, Renicky will bat. And he will walk. It's a 19. That's a walk. So Renicky will get his at bat after all. See what he can do. He did hit 25 home runs on the year, so he is dangerous. 5 is in play. And we get an 80. An 80 in play is not dangerous at all. That's a fly out to center. And the inning's over. So top of the ninth we go. Don Stanhouse, Stan the Man Unusual, going to go try to pitch the second inning here. His second inning of work to earn the save. He is up by the score of 8-4. So actually there would not be a save. He'll just get the satisfaction of being out there to end the game. But he missed the save by one run. All right, Willie Stargell steps things up to lead off the top of the ninth. It's an 8, which is patient. So Stargell looking to get something started here. Patient 85 is not going to do it. Patient 85 is a ground ball to Dower at second. One away, and that'll bring up Bill Madlock. Madlock, an 8, is patient. And a 45. Patient 45 for Madlock is a base hit. So Madlock gets himself a single. Brings up the catcher, Ed Ott. Ed Ott. 11. 11 is ballpark. And it's a 4, so we're in the wheelhouse. Ed Ott's wheelhouse, though, only goes to 10 for a home run. It's a 95, so that's not going to happen. 95 is a fly to right for out number 2. So down to the last out now, it's Phil Garner. Phil Garner. And then a pinch hitter for DeColvey. 5, if it gets that far, that is. Patient for Garner. And it's a 53. Patient 53. He gets plunked. He gets hit by a pitch. Second Pirate batter to be plunked in this game. And it will extend it one more batter. And the Pirates are going to have to go to their bench again. They're almost out of pinch hitters. They're really running low here. And it looks like they're going to have to turn to... Matt Alexander, very seldom used. In fact, I don't even think he was eligible for the World Series. So I'm going to go with what he might have been, because I don't think Rennie Stennett was. I think he was there early on, but we'll go with Rennie Stennett because he had more at-bats. Alexander only had 13 at-bats on the year. He was mostly a runner. But you know what? I think he was on the World Series roster and Stennett was not. So we'll get it straight here. We're going to go with Matt Alexander just because we need a body out there. We're at the pitcher spot. Should have done a double switch on Bill Robinson and didn't think about it. But when it's an 8-4 game, sometimes you don't think about those things. But anyway, Matt Alexander is going to pinch hit against Stanhouse with two outs and two on. It's a four, which is patient. And Matt Alexander, 1-40, will keep the game going. Anything above 40 and the game is over. It's a 94. The game is going to be over. 94 is a fly to right. And the ball game is over. It wasn't pretty, but the Orioles change history and win the 1979 World Series by the final score of 8-4. We'll be right back with the totals. Okay, final totals. Orioles, 8 runs, 9 hits, 1 error. The Pirates, 4 runs, 10 hits, no errors. And with McGregor being tossed so early, the starting pitcher did not go 5 innings, so the official scorer has discretion of who to give the win to. I'm going to give it to Sammy Stewart. He came in after the ejection, pitched an inning and 2/3, and slammed the door. And at that point, the Orioles were only ahead 3-1, so the game was definitely in question. So he had the tougher outing. By the time the other pitchers got in there, Martinez and Stoddard and so forth, the Orioles pretty much had the game in hand. So I'm going to give it to Sammy Stewart as the official scorer. And the losing pitcher was starter Jim Bibby because he gave up the 3 runs and the Pirates never tied the game after that. You'd like to give it to Romo because he pitched so poorly, but officially the loss goes to Bibby. And lots of stars in the game. There were 3 home runs, one by Doug DeSense, one by Murray. Actually, there were 4 home runs, one by Singleton, one by Murray, one by DeSense, and one by the pinch hitter Kelly. Murray was 2-for-3 with a home run, a walk, and a single. Let's see here. John Lowenstein had 2 doubles, so he certainly did well. DeSense was 2-for-4. But it was really, I think, the blow that did it was Singleton. His 2-run homer in the bottom of the third after the Pirates had tied the score in the top of the third. With 2 outs, Garcia gets a 2-out single, and then Singleton hit that home run. I think that kind of set the tone for the rest of the game. And so if we had to pick an MVP, I think we'd go with Ken Singleton on that because of his home run and when it happened. So that's going to do it. History rewritten as the Orioles win Game 7 of the 1979 World Series. And like I said, the dice version of payoff pitch, I'm still learning some of the ins and outs of base runner advancement, especially when there are 2 outs or when the infield's in. So I may have made a couple mistakes there. I don't know. I was looking in the charts and couldn't find the answer I wanted. For anyone that's a payoff pitch expert, if they would please leave a comment to let me know what I should have done on a particular at-bat, whether a runner should have advanced or not, especially an infield in play. Since it was out of the tough part of the pitching card, I just defaulted and said the runner had to hold, but I may have been wrong on that. So I'm learning the dice version. I'm pretty comfortable with the FAC version, the fast action card version, but the dice version, I actually like the dice version better, except for looking up on all the charts. If it wasn't for the charts, I would really love the dice version. But, sometimes maybe I'll start playing the dice version and mix in the runner advancement using the fast action cards. I think some people will do a hybrid. Maybe I'll start doing that. I've done a lot of History Maker Baseball recently. Still doing the 1987 Braves replay. Done some other things with the fictional sets. And, of course, I'm playing Stratomatic quite a bit as well. But thought I'd bring out payoff pitch and give that another go. And thought I would do the 79 World Series since I was thinking about that the other day. I was 14 years old, so it was right in my wheelhouse, so to speak, of being a little leaguer and really following baseball for the first time at an age where I can actually remember what happened. I remember when the Orioles were up 3-1 and how everybody thought the series was over, and the Pirates, of course, come back and win 3 straight, which I believe at the time was probably unprecedented. So that's going to do it from here. Hope everybody has a wonderful time whatever you're doing as far as gaming goes. And we'll see you down the road.